Hey everyone, welcome back to my channel. My name is Emily and I talk a lot about Salesforce. Today we're going to be going over how to use the data import wizard within Salesforce. So there are a few different data upload tools that you can use. One is going to be the data import wizard. That's kind of the first step. Second step is going to be the data loader. And the third step is trying to find a third party app. There are different use cases for each of these different items. But let's go ahead and hop into the data import wizard as I explain it. I'm going to go to setup. Go to data import wizard. Okay, and this is the only tool that is going to off the bat be natively within the Salesforce setup. I'm going to launch the wizard. Okay, so there are limits to the data import wizard. And I like to think of these limits as being something that a data administrator would use rather than a system administrator would use. So you are limited by the number of records to 50,000 records at a time. And you're limited to the accounts and contacts, objects, leads, solutions, campaign members, those five objects, as well as any custom objects that you may have within your Salesforce org. Whereas if you use the data loader or a third party tool, then you'd be able to do all objects. That's like the big difference between the data loader and the data import wizard is you are limited on the objects and the number of records that you can do with data import wizard. And then when you go to the data loader, it'll likely be any other objects that aren't listed here, as well as anything from 50K records up to 5 million records. And then anything past 5 million, you'd likely use a third party tool. So I am going to select leads here because I do have a lead list, a CSV of different leads that I want to import as an admin. So we can choose what we want to do with this record. We can add new records, we can add update existing records with this, or we can add and update existing records. I'm going to select this last one. I will match lead by, you can choose name, email, or Salesforce ID. I'm going to select name. You can assign new leads to whichever source. And then we can assign it using a standard rule or no rule at all. You can send an email out, assign the leads to campaigns, trigger workflow rules and processes. I'm going to leave those alone. I'm going to select CSV. Choose the file from my downloads, leads, and then from here I can select next. All right, so here we're going to map our different fields that we have. So we have, let's see, an unmapped field, and it just says it's column one, so I don't think that's necessary. And then we have, that's probably just a blank column. Then we have name is matched up to name, phone matched up to phone, company is matched up to company. And then we can see some of the examples that are in the list, which that's the extent of all of the records that we have. So everything is looking good. Now I'm going to select next. It will map the three fields, which we do only have three fields. One is going to be unmapped, but it is a blank column because I know the data. And I will start import. Select OK. And let's look for status here of the records. And it looks like it has been completed. And if we were to go into our leads, go to all, we can see that the three leads that we have uploaded right there are there assigned to myself. So that is how you use the data import wizard. You do have other options besides leads, but leads are the most common use case for the data import wizard. Thank you so much for joining me. If you have any questions, be sure to drop them down below in the comment section and I will try and get back to you as soon as possible. Like, subscribe, all those things. Check out the courses down below on Salesforce, new users, admins, and the app builder exam. And if you'd like to subscribe to my email list, you can do that at salesforceemily.com. Thank you so much, and I will catch you in the next one.